talk about the BASEL models in place. What is the underlying theory behind BASEL models? How they are made? What are their individual components? Guys, any questions before we move ahead? Is fine. Yeah. Okay. Great. Okay. Okay. Great. So as you know about the BASEL model, BASEL again is a, again I'm repeating, it's a set of regulatory requirements to assess the capital adequacy of the bank, and they mostly cover the two types of risk. Expected loss, which is a known risk, unexpected loss, which is an unknown risk. So according to the BASEL Accords, the risks are covered by provisions or allowances on loans and lease losses, and unexpected losses, which are covered by capital reserves. And again, the capital which we calculate is Tier 1 and Tier 2 capital, which is weighted by risk-weighted assets. Now, when you are preparing the BASEL models, your objective is to calculate the unexpected and expected losses. Expected losses are usually the mean or average portfolio losses which will cover, and unexpected would be a deviation from those expected losses. So guys, again, although the unexpected losses are very less to happen, they are pretty rare, but when they happen, they create a severe impact and they can give a blow to the business. And again, it's, these are regulatory models, so we have to follow the regulatory guidelines. So when you talk about the BASEL models, it's about the different kinds of scorecards which are put into place. So against the customer, you give them a score in terms of their risk exposures. If you talk about the expected loss, the expected loss is calculated as a probability of default multiplied by loss. So loss is the amount which we think that we will lose, and PD is the probability that a customer will go default. Say for example, I am holding an account or a credit card with a bank since few years, and out of those models which I have run, I have 80% probability that I will go default in the next 1 year. So my expected loss would be 0.8 into amount of loss which I have calculated. Similarly, if I have a low probability of default or PD, say 0.2, my expected loss would be 0.2 into loss. So my expected loss value would be lower in such a case. So probability plays a very big role in calculating the expected losses. So what I do is I calculate this probability of default for each and every customer which is existing in my portfolio. Say I will, Bryn Mawr will be having a separate probability of default. ASIP will be having a different probability of default, and so on and so forth. And that's how we will calculate the expected loss. Now, after calculating that expected loss value at an individual level, my job is to check the healthiness of the portfolio. I'm not actually concerned that whether X customer is going bad or Y customer is going bad, but when I talk at an overall level, I have to ensure the healthiness of the bank, of my bank. So what I will do is, I will calculate the PD or expected losses of individual customers, and then I will sum them up. So that I will say, as a bank, I have this much expected loss, which will be a single number given out to the regulatory. Yes, we can further divide it into different segments on type of customers and so on and so forth. But overall, that one number is the golden, is the gold mine, which everyone is looking for. Now, along with PD, two important things which we need to calculate in Basel models are LGD and EAD. So PD is probability of default. It is a percentage estimate. Loss given default is actually the exposure the account have at default. Okay. So exposure at default is basically, for example, my credit line is $1,000. And when I actually defaulted or stopped making my payments, I had consumed $500 out of that $1,000. So my exposure at default is $500, not $1,000, which was my credit line. So how much exposure or credit exposure I had when I have defaulted, that is my exposure at default. That value is calculated first at an account level, and then it is aggregated at a portfolio level. Now, for the customers who have defaulted, there would be some recoveries. Say, out of my 20 million customers, say 100K defaulted. As a bank, I will try to, yes, Vishal, EAD is exposure at default, outstanding amount. Yeah, so I was on recoveries. Yeah. So as a bank, say I have 100K customers which have defaulted, right? Now as a bank, I will also try to recover the money which is right now lying in the customers. I will try to make some phone calls. I will try to readjust their portfolio, forbear some of their losses, so whatever the maximum payments I can get it from the customers when they have actually defaulted is called recoveries. So in terms of unsecured loans like credit cards, it would be the any kind of payment I am able to receive or get from the customers. That would be my recovery. In terms of secured loans like mortgages, so when a customer has defaulted on the mortgage, I get a hold of the property, I sell it off, and whatever money I have got out of that sale, minus the expenses which I have incurred in terms of doing that sale, that would be my recovery for that particular loan. So after deducting those recoveries, whatever remaining loss I have in my portfolio is my loss given default. Given my n number of customers have defaulted, what is the actual loss I have in my portfolio? So recoveries are taken out before calculating LGD. Below is a simple equation for calculating the complete expected loss, which is a product of PD into LGD into EAD. Okay. So this is how I completely calculate my expected losses in terms of Basel model. Now, as you know, as you have studied in the previous slide, there are three main components. One is PD, one is LGD, and one is EAD. We will now study them into a bit detail and with some examples. Now, PD, or probability of default, as the name says, is the probability or a chance event that a customer will default in the next 12 months. So, say Vishal has a chances that with 50% probability he will default in the next 12 months. Mrinmoy has a chance of 20% of going default in the next month. And Asif has a chance of, say, 50% of going default in the next month. And Santosh has a chance of 90% going next month. So guys, these are just some random numbers. I know you make all your payments on time and you will not go default. I just took a hypothetical example. Okay. Now, there are two types of models which you make. So one is called point in time, and another is through the cycle. And when you talk about, I will explain through the cycle here only, because that is the main component of probability of default models. So when you talk about PD models, they take a very long horizon of data, say for 10 years. So we will pull the data for the last 10 years of the customer's portfolio and their performance, and we will try to build a model on that for the next 12 months. So why do we use such a long duration of the data? Because when a customer comes into your account, initially they might do very different kind of behavior at different intervals, but once a particular time period has passed, their behavior on the portfolio becomes much more stabilized. Also, when we take a very long horizon of data, we incorporate different kind of strategies, business risk, market risk, and the economic situations our portfolio has faced and how they have reacted according to it. So this helps you to incorporate lot of conditions which has actually happened with your portfolio in the last few years, and then try to build a model out of it. So basically, our objective is to monitor an account for a sufficiently long period so that we can build a more stable, a more comprehensive, and a more representative model. But what is the problem if I don't take such a long period, or I take an account which is not seasoned well? Why I cannot do that? Because lot of times it happens when a customer comes into your account, initially they will just do some expenditures, they will have outstandings, but to check whether the customer is defaulting or not, you need to observe them for a particular time. Say for example, if a customer has to go bad or you have to declare that person as a loss, you will monitor that person's account for 180 days. So if you take an account at a very initial level, when they have actually come into your portfolio, they would be just doing expenditures. But actually, they might be defaulting in the next 12 months or 24 months. So if you pick up the customers which are very much new into your portfolio, you will just observe their good behavior, that they are doing expenditures and they are not in loss, because actually they have not passed their 180-day period. So no account will be in the loss. And in that way, you will assign them very low probability of default. And it will drive down your numbers for expected losses. And it will not be a true representation of your portfolio in the longer run. So what happens in Basel, the non-seasoned loans or the loans which are shorter duration, which have just started or on our books for a very less time period, they are treated separately and their score is their scoring is done separately, and their buffer for them is also assigned, so that their tendencies for default in the future point of time can be covered. So they are completely treated differently. So any kind of models which you make, whether you are making Basel model, whether you are making CCAR models or anything, the maturity level and account, a customer account has reached, that plays a very important role. Okay. Now let's talk about exposure and default. Again, as you know, exposure of default is the bank value that bank is exposed at the time of default. Exposure is the amount of outstanding when the account might go default. Default is when account is unlikely to meet its outstanding obligations on the debt, or they are 90 plus delinquent. We will cover more about 180 days, 90 days. Hi, I hope everyone can hear me. So Brain Boy, just 10 minutes more, 10-15 minutes more, then today's session will end. So I hope you are able to bear and take this up. Okay. I am on slide 26. Exposure at default. So exposure at default, we were talking about which accounts are directly considered at default, the bankruptcies, the account which have gone bankrupt while they are still on bucket 1 or bucket 0, they are considered at default, or any kind of accounts where some specific provisions are raised. So those are all considered as default. Now you have revolving products and non-revolving products into your bank. So on both you have to calculate your exposure. So below there is an example of EAD. Below there is an example of EAD, but I have already explained you how do you calculate the EAD.
So I think that is fine and we can move ahead. A very brief example is stated here. Let's say an account has a credit card with a limit of 1 lakh. The person has used 60K out of that limit, and now 20K is outstanding. So outstanding is the number, what is the payment which is due. So 20K is exposure of the bank for this account. So this is a small example. I think I will give you the material. You can read it at your own pace as well. This is much similar to what I have explained before. I will quickly move on to LGD. And LGD would be the last thing which we will cover for today. Then we will disperse off for today's session. As I told you before, LGD is the loss earned by the bank from the defaulted account due to lack of recoverability. So the loss which has happened minus the recoveries is actually a loss given default. So if you see below, LGDs can be simply defined as 1 minus recovery. So whatever is your recovery, minus 1 is your LGD rate. So LGD includes your all indirect and direct cost components associated with the recovery process. So any cost which is included in while recovering, that is also taken into account and deducted from the losses. Again, whenever you are building any model, you build it on two types of accounts: the accounts which are already defaulted and or which are called bad, and it depends what kind of a definition you have for the default accounts or bad accounts, and the accounts which are non-defaulted. So you will assign a probability to them on the basis of your models, that what are their chances of giving you loss in the next 1 year.